Welcome to EPG Patashala. I am A. Poshadri, Assistant Professor, College of Food Science and Technology, Professor Jay Shankar, Telangana State Agricultural University, Hyderabad. Today I am going to speak on microwave blanching, sterilization and finished drying module under course of Advances in Food Sciences and Technology. So in this microwaves, in previous class we discussed about microwave heating applications in food industry. So in this course we discuss applications and blanching, what are the applications, so where we use this microwave for blanching, sterilization and drying. So few points we already discussed, and in this we elaborately we discuss about blanching, sterilization, finished drying of different food items. So as we know, microwaves interact with polar water molecules and charged ions. The friction resulting from the molecule alignment and migration of charged ions in rapidly alternative electromagnetic field generates heats within the foods. So that means when you are pumping or when you are passing microwaves, and the water present in the food get charged up, and they migrate, and because of their migration alignment, then heat's generating, and that heat will warm up your food, or heat will sterilize your food, or pasteurize your food, or blanch your food. So that is all about microwave heating. So as we know, microwave heating at 915 megahertz or 2450 megahertz is the most commonly used frequency for the food industry. Okay, to protect the most processed shelf stable high moisture foods today are heat treated with pasteurized hot water or a steam to kill bacteria. Prolonged exposure to high temperature leads to poor product quality. So here when you use the conventional methods for pasteurization or sterilization, when we expose the food for higher temperature for longer period, what happens, you may find some quality deterioration in terms of loss of nutrients or color changes or loss of organoleptic properties. So to minimize these losses or to avoid these issues, and the microwave heating is the one alternative for the conventional heating system. So microwave sterilization is a thermal process that delivers thermal energy to foods under pressure to achieve inactivation of bacteria harmful for human. Sharp reduction in processing time improves color, texture and other sensory attributes of foods while meeting microbial safety requirements. So here that means when you are heating microwave sterilization, so it killing off all pathogens, all microorganisms, and it reduces the loss of nutrients. So by that way it is advantageous over the general methods. So we have seen different applications of microwave heating. So the most suitable application is making of chips, heating of baking products, or preheating, or blanching are the applications. So first food industry, this microwave heating started using in 1930 for heating of the mashed potatoes and chips, and then it is also used for the poultry products and tampering and thawing. So that means when you keep a food in the refrigerator and to bring the temperature of the food to a normal temperature, or when a food kept from, when the food when food brought from the deep freezer or a frozen condition to a room temperature, then they need to be thawed. That means we need to bring the desired room temperature or a 0 degree centigrade. For that reason we use this microwave heating in the earlier days. If you see today in most of the houses we can see the microwave heating systems, but not in industry, only in few industries are using these microwave heating systems. And even though few industries uses it also, they don't disclose their technologies to the others. So the microwave heating advantages are there and certain disadvantages are there. Because of that, they're commercially not much successful, and only few industries are practicing this microwave heating systems. So in baking process, to make bread, cakes, pastry, etc. by the help of microwaves on industrial scale can be found. An enhanced throughput is achieved by an acceleration of the baking, where the additional space needs for microwave power generators are negligible. Okay, when we want maximum output, or when we want in a big scale or a large scale, what happens there, the microwave generation power is not sufficient. So if you want to use in a large scale, then microwave generator power should be enhanced to meet that requirements. So an advantage of combined processes is the possible use of, for example, earlier days, what happened when you combine this microwave heating with some other technology. In conventional baking process, because of half high temperature, some 180 or 220 some degrees Celsius, when you use that, in that case the enzyme alpha amylase, which is present in the wheat, and it breakdowns the starch of wheat into simple sugars, and simple sugars further to reproduces CO2, then the puffiness will be increases. But what happens in conventional method, because of that high heating, that alpha amylase enzyme get inactivated, then that its action destroyed. So whereas in case of the microwave heating system, so this enzyme will not inactivated, then enzyme starts acting and simple sugars forms and CO2 releases and better puffing will be there. So in order to have better crust, crumb color of the bread, you know, crust and crumb of the bread, when bread is there, so the top one is the crust and crumb is upper one. So that crust color, crust and crumb colors and will be the good in conventional method, not in the microwave heating. So when combined microwave heating and conventional method, in conventional method you will have better crust and crumb, and in microwave heating better retention of this enzyme and better puffing action will be takes place. So when you combine this conventional heating and the microwave heating in one place, then you will have a better result in your product. And in earlier days in baking, they use pan. So earlier the pan is the pan which is used for baking was expensive, and later scientists in 1982 they have patented one pan which is heat resistant metal and which is using in microwave ovens. So that is also one advantage nowadays. So if the baking becomes simple because of this metal baking pan which is developed in 1982. The main use of microwaves in the baking industry today is the microwave finishing, when the low heat conductivity leads to considerable higher baking times in the conventional process. So next important application of this microwave in food industry is thawing and tempering. So thawing and tempering are the important thing, because in thawing process, a frozen meat, a frozen fish, or a frozen vegetable, or a frozen butter is there. So which is when you take from the fridge, then it is in a frozen condition, and when you use directly for a cooking purpose, when you use directly as ingredient in food, then that time your quality will be deteriorating. So for that reason, so we'll, after taking from the fridge or after taking from the frozen state, and we are thawing it, that means we are bringing the temperature to 0 degrees centigrade, whatever the ice present in that product, product will be converted into water form. So that means to bring the material into thaw stage, then we use the microwave system. In tampering means here, tampering is something, for example, in meat industry, we have to cut the meat. They are in big size and different sizes and shapes, or lamb, what you call, legs, or the hindos, or other bacon, ham parts are very big in size. So to cut that size, and we have to keep the frozen temperatures, and for example, the temperature is around minus 5 to 20 degrees Celsius here. So this is the minimum temperature at which the meat can be boned or other products cut or separated by hand. Lower temperature, example, minus 5 to minus 2 degrees Celsius are acceptable for product that is destined for mechanical chopping, but such material is tampered rather than thawed. So tampered means, so we are maintaining that temperatures. We should not confuse with thawing and tampering. Thawing is we are bringing the material to 0 degrees centigrade. In tampering, we are keeping the, we are holding the material minus 2 to minus 5 to minus 2 degrees Celsius. So this is the difference. So here in thawing is doing for to convert the ice into water, whereas tampering is we are maintaining the stiffness and to cut the meat easily. For that reason, we are maintaining the temperature. So in thawing process, use of electromagnetic radiation to generate heat within the food. In selecting a thawing or tampering system for industrial use, a balance must be there between the thawing time, appearance, and bacteriological condition of the product, processing problems such as effluent disposal and the capital and operating cost of the respective system. So when you do thawing process, there may be a water loss, or there may be a nutrient, there may be effluents may generate. So the disposal of this effluent is also a problem, and bacteria may starts growing in that condition. So disposal and appearance and what you call prevention of bacteria is also important aspect in thawing process. So that's why we should keep all the points in mind. So before we go for thawing by the microwave heating. So the thawing and tampering process. So after the determination of this thawing time and time is the important criteria before we govern the thawing and tampering processes. Appearance, bacteriological condition and weight loss are important if the material is to be sold in the thawed condition, but are less if it is for processing. For example, when you want to sell the thawed product, so what happens during thawing process, we lose water, we lose some nutrients, or we lose something. So that means the weight of 1 kg meat becomes some 900 grams. That means we may lose some moisture. So that means it's a saleable weight loss will be there for the seller. So we should consider this point also, because when you do excess thawing also, we'll lose the sellable weight. It's a loss to the seller. In the picture you can see microwave heating. And before this microwave heating in drying process, we should understand the what is constant rate period, first falling rate period, second falling rate period. As we in drying process, so when we dry the grain, and the moisture present in the grain on top of the grain will be removed faster. So that means the whatever the moisture on the surfaces of the grain will be removed quickly than the moisture present inside the grain. So what happens when you dry and first half an hour, first 3 hours, so drying takes place quickly, and next 3 hours drying takes place, the loss of moisture will be very less. The gradual reduction of moisture is very less. So this happens because of that. So what happened, we do some conditioning. So after 5 hours of 6 hours of drying, and we stop drying, and we pull the grain once again heap together, and we allow it to distribute the moisture among the grain. That means, so that is called conditioning. So when we do such process, then there is a, we can save the energy, and we can do better drying also. So in this graph you can see, so first drying, first falling rate period drying took place very fastly. In second falling rate period, drying took place slowly. You can see the graph very clearly. You can find this. So starting one is a constant rate period, and the quick reduction is a first falling rate period, and slow reduction is a second falling rate period. Next, the benefits of microwave drying, we should first have a quick look at the much more conventional method of air drying. So during this period, the surface is kept wet by the constant capillary driven flow of water from within the particles. So that means the grain, the moisture present in the surface of the grain will be removed quickly than the moisture present inside the grain. So in drying process, the main cause for the application of microwaves is the acceleration of the process, which are without using microwaves, limited by low thermal conductivity, especially in products of low moisture content. So as we know that because of water, polarization of dielectric heating happens because of polarization of water molecules. So if moisture is less in the grain, then that time the drying process is not good in case of microwave heating. So it is not suitable. When moisture is less moisture, foods drying is not suitable in this case. Correspondingly, sensorial and nutritional damage caused by long drying times or high surface temperatures can be prevented. But here the advantage is that when you use conventional drying system, where we are exposing our food to very long period, then there may be a loss, a nutrient loss, or damages, color changes may happen. But in case of microwave heating, those problems may not be there. And it also the avoidance of case hardening. So in a grains, in a vegetables kind of thing, there is a hardening is a problem. When you dry the grains, it becomes shrinkled and the surface become hardened. So that problem will not be there in case of microwave heating. two cases of microwave drying are possible, drying at atmospheric pressure and that with applied vacuum condition. So when you combine microwave heating with vacuum drying, you will have the better results. Or when you combine the microwave heating with air dryers, will have the better results. So that kind of combination can be used very well to have better results, better drying results in the final product. So already in this previous class we discussed. So drying for the drying up your pasta, vermicelli, noodles, dried onions and mashed potatoes or potato chips. In that case, so drying combination with vacuum drying is more suitable and we'll have better results. Or microwave assisted freeze drying. So freeze drying is expensive. Again, the microwave assisted freeze drying is, we can reduce the cost and moreover we'll have the better quality product than other conventional drying methods. So here in picture you can see very clear the microwave sterilized salmon and rice. That other side we will have conventionally processed canned salmon. So how the difference you can find. So here in this microwave one is good in quality, and whereas the conventionally processed canned salmon is the by looking at the quality we can say that so this conventionally dried product is not much appealing when compared to the microwave sterilized product. So here in this microwave, as you might have seen in several times in baking industry, small bakeries or wherever you go in any bakery you will find, or in your home also you can see this how microwave weak. So magnetron is there, from magnetron these microwaves are producing, and because of that waves food get heated up. So you can see in this picture. Then next, quality of microwave dried food products. So when you look at the quality, in certain cases when combined this conventional drying or air drying or vacuum drying with the microwave heating, will have the better color and aroma. Some scientists like Venkatesh and Raghavan in 2004, they conducted a study on rosemary. Rosemary is a herb. Herb we use in different exotic cuisines, in the restaurants you will have. In restaurants, in different food items we use as a herb. Okay, so when you use this household microwave heating for drying up rosemary, and they observed that the aroma or the quality of the product is maintained very well when compared with the conventional drying. And other scientists called Corkida and Marulus, and they measured the color and porosity of microwave dried apples, bananas and carrots, and they found that the product which is dried under microwave have better what you call porosity and better color when compared to the conventional. So these are the quality. So in terms of quality, the microwave dried products are superior than the conventionally dried products. Even the aroma, the quality of aroma, the flavor coming from the product also can be preserved very well with the help of this microwave heating system. Microwave drying applied in the food industry. Microwave drying is not a common in the food industry. There are many reasons for its limited use. The number one is the technical problems described above were not well understood in the past. This has led to some failures which have surely discouraged the other potential users. Shipman 2001 has listed a number of formerly successful applications that have been discontinued. Among these are the finished drying of potato chips, pasta drying, snack drying and the finished drying of biscuits and crackers. It is apparently not always the microwave process itself, but rather changes in the circumstance of production that make the competing technologies more successful. In spite of these difficulties, there are some current applications. So as mentioned, Shipman 2001, serial cooking and drying with a production rate of nearly 1 ton per hour. So they developed a system, or they standardized or they optimized the microwave heating for drying of 1 ton per hour of pasta. So they can easily dry that product with the help of a microwave in Italy, in one company they are using. And few other companies also, meat extracts companies also they are using. But few companies are not disclosing that they are using microwave heating for their food application because of the confidentiality issues. Next, sterilization and pasteurization. As we see how the conventional heating is used for sterilization and pasteurization. So when you use sterilization and pasteurization by conventional method, certainly there is a loss of certain vital heat sensitive nutrients. So that can be avoided with the help of microwave heating. But in most cases, the results claimed couldn't be reproduced or the lagged an exact temperature distribution determination. The probability of non-thermal effects becomes clear when the quantum of energy of photons, of microwaves or of thermal radiator and the energy of molecular bonds are compared. Next, blanching using microwave processing. So what do you mean by blanching? So blanching, why do we need to blanch the material? For example, when we don't blanch any vegetable or any green leafy vegetables or some fruits, what happens? The enzymes present in that vegetable, the enzyme present in the fruits, an enzyme called polyphenol oxidase or peroxidase. These are the enzymes which are present in fruits, vegetables or some leafy vegetables. So this enzyme starts acting on that material and they change the color of that material. So if we do blanching, what happens? Because of blanching, that the enzymes get inactivated, then there won't be any color changes in future processing stages. So that means, so exposing of a material to a hot water or a steam or a hot air or a microwave heating for a few seconds to inactivate an enzyme is called blanching. And subsequently, we cool the material immediately after blanching. So by doing blanching, we can inactivate the enzyme, we can reduce the surface area to volume ratio, we can preserve the color of the product, we can remove some anti-nutritional factors, and we can improve the color, we can improve the flavor, we can improve the texture. So for that reason, we do blanching process. So the efficiency of the blanching process is usually based on the inactivation of one of the heat resistant enzymes, peroxidase or polyphenol oxidases. Blanching has additional benefits such as the cleansing of the product, decreasing of the initial microbial load, exhausting gas from the plant tissues, and the preheating before the processing. So apart from color improvement or size reduction, and also useful, it will also save the energy in next subsequent processes because we are heating your material to some 70 to 80 degrees Celsius. So when you do the conventional blanching, what happens? We do generally blanching in hot water. So some components may leach out in the water, some vital nutrients. Or sometimes what happens, thermal effects on the some vital nutrients. So this won't happen because in microwave heating we are not using water, because the water present in the vegetable or water present in the leafy vegetable or water present in the fruits and vegetable acts as a polar solvent, and by heating it causes dielectric heating, the metal get heated up. So here the leaching of nutrients, the loss of nutrients are minimized when we use the microwave heating when compared with the conventional heating. A still further advantage is that the microwave blanching enables a finished blanching of the center section more quickly and without being affected by thick or non-uniform sections. So the material uniformly heated up, the enzymes present in the material get inactivated uniformly, then there won't be any color changes in the next processes. Next, advantages of microwave blanching. Microwave heating involves conversion of electromagnetic energy into heat by selective adsorption and dissipation. Microwave heating is attractive for heating of foods due to its origin within the material, fast temperature rise, controllable heat deposition, and easy cleanup. And the very high frequencies used in microwave heating allow for rapid energy transfers and thus high rates of heating. These rates are main advantages of this technique. Nowadays, scientists are developing a unique system for microwave blanching. The most likely for future for microwave food processing is in the continued development of unique single system that overcome the limitations discussed previously. Compared to the development of traditional blanching system, it is still a change to design appropriate equipment for microwave blanching. So again, we need to develop an appropriate equipments for microwave, because microwave in large scale, so blanching of 1 ton vegetables or blanching of 2 ton green leaf vegetables. So we need to design such a mechanism where we can hold this material. So and And again, the power required, the magnetron power required is also important for this. So, developing a machine or compatible machine or compatible generators also important task in task for the developing of right blanching equipment by using microwave heating. And next, this microwave heating is also using for the wastewater treatment. In the industry, in every industry, effluents are generating, and these effluents can be sometimes in countries like in India, a few industries are neglecting the rules or the environmental protection or sustainability of the environment, and they are pumping all the waste water or effluents to the environment. Then it is again its effect on environment and pollution, and all this leads to further adverse climate condition for the human being. So, before pumping these effluents into the atmosphere, it's better to treat these effluents once with the some heating system to kill the pathogen, to kill the microorganisms, or to inactivate some other component. So, when you pass these materials through microwave heating system, then all they get inactivated, and the only the safe effluents will be pumped into the atmosphere, and there is no pollution in the atmosphere. That is the advantage with this. So this technology again under process, again we are heating water, and some smoke is generating, some other unwanted materials are generating. So this, the 100% effluent treatment may not be possible, but still this research is under process, that their scientists are trying to develop a appropriate equipment for treating of this effluents of an industry. Microwaves can be an interesting candidate to fulfill the need for this kind of process, and this is particularly true if the matrix of the waste materials exhibits dielectric properties. So that's what. So when effluents having more of dielectric property or more of polar charged ions, then that time you can use this microwave heating very well for heating of this wastewater. And next, when you see the quality or safety aspects, so for example microwave heating, so waves and frequency, we are talking electromagnetic waves, and for example these waves are going, and what you call molecular friction alteration alignment, it may leads to radioactive developments. So absolutely there is no problem with the microwave heating when we use for the food, because what happened, the food processed by this microwave technology is safe for consumption, because the microwave energy is changed to heat as soon as it is absorbed by the food. It cannot make the food radioactive or contaminated. When the microwave energy is turned off and the food is removed from the oven, there is no residual radiation remaining in the food. In this regard, microwave oven is much like an electric light that stops glowing when it is turned off. So there is no question of radioisotopes development or radioactive components generation in the food. So microwaves are not radioactive. So in safety point of view, microwave heating is not having any adverse effect on the human health conditions. So in summary, in microwave heating, we are using two different frequencies, 18915 and 2450 megahertz. These two frequencies, and by making use of dielectric properties of the water, here polar water, especially polar solvent. So by using of these property, we are applying microwave heating with the air drying system, or with the vacuum drying system, or with the freeze drying. When combined with microwave heating with air drying or vacuum drying or freeze drying, we will get the better results in product quality and safety, and also blanching purpose also. When you use microwave heating in general blanching process, there may be a leaching out of nutrients, there may be a leaching out of color, so that problem can be minimized with the help of microwave heating, and even thawing process or tampering process also. So to get a better results or to minimize the weight losses and all these things, temperature and time data dependency, if you maintain thoroughly, then you will have a better quality even in thawing or tampering process and blanching process. So absolutely there is no problem with the safety in terms of safety of microwave heating. So during microwave heating, no radioactivity components are forming, there is no radioisotopes in the food system. So it is a kind of switching on a light or switching off of a light. So microwave heating, when you on it, we are switching on a light. When you off it, then it is a switching off a light. So that means, so the absolutely the operation or applying a microwave heating for any food application has no harmful effect on human being. Thank you.